Nearly 25 million pesos worth of illegal vape products confiscated by Philippine authorities. The illicit items were being sold at a milk tea shop near the premises of an elementary school. Lady Vicentia reports.
About 400 boxes of vape products were confiscated by the Philippine Trade Department and the PNP Southern Police District in an operation in Baclaran, Paranaque on Tuesday. These were discovered in a milk tea shop used as a front for selling vape. The site is only 20 meters away from Baclaran Elementary School and operating without registration to sell such commodity. Under the vape law, selling vape products within 100 meters of schools is prohibited to prevent minors from being enticed to use electronic cigarettes. The DTI also found out that the brand of these confiscated items was issued a preliminary order and was ordered to halt operations.
I-establish po namin more or less ang pattern niya mula nang naglabas March 15 preliminary order, sinususpinde ng DTI ang trading, meaning manufacturing, importing, distribution and selling. Sinundan na po namin ang particular na brand na ito.
The items were also labeled with flavor descriptors also prohibited under the vape law. The confiscated vape products are valued at 24.8 million pesos.
Sa Flava, sila yung paulit-ulit na nahuhuli natin na parating may flavor descriptors, parating may mga event na gumagamit ng influencer. Nagkataon lang, nung pag-open, lahat nakita natin, ang puro stock nila, yung tatak na yan. Pero marami pang ibang brands na nagva-violate ng vape law at lahat yan, hinuhuli natin sa online at saka sa physical monitoring natin.
An initial investigation revealed that the milk tea shop is owned by two Chinese nationals. A notice of violation has been given to the owners for multiple violations of the vape law. The DTI also committed to hold the manufacturer accountable for violating the preliminary order issued to them. Lady Vicentia, ABS-CBN News.
The agricultural damage due to the prolonged drought caused by the El Nino phenomenon nearing 4 billion pesos. Government's El Nino task force said over 100 cities and municipalities in the country were also put under a state of calamity. El Nino is projected to affect all but two provinces by the end of this month.
Nasa 3.94 billion na po ang danyo sa agrikultura. That's equivalent to about 66,000 hectares. Pero I would like to emphasize po na 78% ng 66,000 hectares na yon may chance of recovery or salvageable pa. Ibig sabihin, kahit po yung itsura ng taniman tuyong-tuyo o brown na siya, mapapakinabangan po yung 78% ng pananim doon. Ulat mula sa isang international financial.
Meanwhile, State Weather Bureau PAGASA projects by the end of May, the water level at Angat Dam could fall near its minimum operating level, while that of Pantabangan Dam could increase to a figure slightly above its MOL. Magat Dam, on the other hand, could reach its normal high of 193 meters in the same month. Now here's a quick look at the flash business headlines from overseas. Embattled Chinese property developer Country Garden Holdings receives an approval to further delay payments on three onshore bonds, staving off its first local default for now. Bloomberg reports noteholders concluded voting this week to extend coupon and principal installment payments until September. Country Garden already defaulted on dollar bonds last year, becoming one of the biggest casualties of the real estate crisis that's rattled financial markets and the economy. Moving on, U.S. Secretary of State Antony Blinken is in Shanghai for a three-day visit, pushing to resolve a raft of issues threatening the newly gained calm between the two rivals. Now, America's top diplomat will kick off his visit with a meeting with business leaders at the Chinese financial hub. He heads next to Beijing for talks with Chinese Foreign Minister Wang Yi. A meeting with President Xi Jinping also likely. Meanwhile, South Korea's economy grew at the fastest pace in more than 2 years in the first quarter on robust exports beating estimates. GDP for January to March period was 1.3% higher than the preceding 3 months on a seasonally adjusted basis. Now this, the sharpest expansion since the fourth quarter of 2021. And finally, Japanese retail giant 7-1 Holdings wants huge growth for its 7-Eleven convenience store chain globally. It is aiming to boost the global number of 7-Eleven stores by 18% to about 100,000 in 6 years. It also wants the chain to be in 30 countries and regions, up from the current 20.